Okay guys, this is the third log off that pine then. And if you look there, I don't know if you can tell, but there's about an inch of a bend in it, or a bow. So in other words, right there the way it's laying, the right side in the camera is about an inch further that way than the other side is. Okay, I don't know if you can see the bow in it, but you can see it here. So I'm pretty sure you can see it there. So here's the thing with this. If I can't get any 1x12 out of that, and I can get 1x10 out of it. The problem is that end up at the far end up there is 13 inches. Okay, so it's 13 inches up here, 15 down here. Now, I can probably get a couple, maybe one or two 1x12 out of the very middle, but a 13-inch log gives you a 9-inch cant. So, I can get a 9x9 cant out of there, and then basically cut a 1x on one side and then 1x8 on the other sides. So, I think that's the way I'm going to go. Somebody had asked me the other day why I didn't cut a 12x12 cant, or in one of the comments. And just to clarify that, this is a 15-inch log here. The cant for a 15-inch log is 10.5 inches. So that means that the cant would be right about where the top of this rule is, and then you'd be cutting off this and this. Now there's some wood in there, and the good thing about pine is you can take what's known as sapwood and use it in part of the log. It's not going to hurt anything in part of the lumber. So like I say, I could get probably one or two 1x12 out of that, but because it's got a bend in it, I'm just going to go ahead and cut it in a 9-inch. See, I should cut this top, this side, and the bottom and see what I can get out of it, but I guess I'll cut it the same way I've been cutting them. I really hate to waste any pine. I mean, I don't mind wasting oak because I can cut oak up quick. I've got a whole garage full of oak, so that's not my problem. My problem is trying to save the pine. All right, so let's get started with this. What I want to do there is cut off the nicest piece here that'll give me at least a 8-inch or 10-inch board. And then we'll go from there. Yeah, it's nice looking wood. Whenever I cut a log that has a bow in it, and I've said this before, you either get the bow up or sideways. You want it a definite 90 to the cutting blade in some way. Either even to it or a 90 to it. That's 9 inches there. But you can see what I've got as far as weighing goes, the way I have the tape measure there, because of the bend in the log. So that's probably going to make like a 1x8. That bend in there, so I'm just going to square this up and get 1x8 out. See, that board's pretty bulky in the middle. There's a little bit of can or rain on that side. to trim this down then, just like the other one. But we got at least 10 inches there right now. Yesterday I was cutting and I had the bark side to that side, and the day before it was to that side. It's just turned around, that's all, because of the way the log is twisted. So I'm going to just pull this over, and then I'm going to cut the top, and then I'll cut boards out of it. There, that's because of the bend in it. We're in the belly part of the bend. Now I have a little bit of wane on the very bottom of that, and there's going to be some on that first cut on that side. After that, we should be good. Now, if you look at this, the first cut here is 10 inches. When we get down into the after the first cut, we should be able to get 12-inch boards out of here, down to about there, and then we'll be back to 10. So any 12-inch boards we get is a good thing. Now, just keep in mind, if you cut this into a cant right away, you only end up with a 9-inch board. So 12-inch is just 3 more inches of wood that would normally get thrown away per piece. probably going to be a 10. It's 11 and a half inches. I'll probably cut it down to 10. This should be 12. A C grade, but it's not a bad grade. Is going there, that tells you that you're going to get some smaller boards out of that. I can probably get two, this one, and maybe two more, probably one more 1x12, and then the boards are going to consistently get smaller as I go down. So I'm really happy to get those three 1x12 out of there. More logs left from this tree, and I'll probably be cutting them into something other than 1x, although the one doesn't look bad, the other one's got a bend in it. Maybe I'll cut some 2x4s out of that or something, but I want to try and get as much 1x12 out of this as I can, and it's amazing that I can still get it from this tree. It still has the old bark on it there, and what I mean is, you know, it's the older part of the tree. It's still the, let's see, 24 feet off the ground, and then from there up it starts to be a newer green, like a smoother bark, so it's not quite as big, but we'll see what we got here. Thank you. Alright guys, sorry about that, the battery went dead. Those are 1x12 there. You see there's a nice set of four of them. I've already got two 1x10s out of this that I cut prior to these. Now the one has a tiny bit of weight on it, I'm not going to worry about that. Other than that, it looks pretty good. That blade is getting dull, and the way that I can tell is it wants to ride on the board rather than cut straight in. So I cut a little bit off. You saw where I cut some spots off a third of the way down and then halfway down. That's because the blade's not sharp, okay? Now I can cut the rest of these. There's only, I think there's three 1x10 and then a 1x8. So I'll cut the rest of them. I'm gonna leave those 1x12 as they are. But that blade's been on there quite a while. You knew the last time I sharpened it was, man, I think last, maybe 2 weeks ago or better. But either way, it still needs to be sharpened. So I'm gonna just rip these down so they're the size they need to be, and then that's it for this blade. I gotta sharpen it. The one that I have laying on the bed down here by me, this board right here, you can get a 1x10 out of it, but if I do, I have a little wane on this side. So I'm going to get the 1x10, but I want to cut both sides of that. So for right now, I'm just going to cut that one board down to 10 inches. what's wrong here is instead of this being against here, it's against the lug on the bottom, and the way that I'm pushing, I took it down a little. So I'm going to move it down, see if I can't get it straight. See, it's bowing the board on the lug that's here. Yeah. That's what's happening here, it's against the lug. So, 4 1x12, 2 1x10, and 2 1x8. So that's not bad. It's a tiny bit of wing on these, both of these, but it's very, very little. There's about 60 board feet there, so you're looking at around $300, roughly. I just want you to see how nice that wood is. You know, I get all kind of complaints. Somebody the other day made a complaint there that I didn't know what I was doing at all. And I don't know about you, but I'm judging the end results. I don't worry about what somebody says in the middle. I'm just telling you that, that's all. These are some beautiful boards, and when they're dried, they're gonna be really nice. Okay, what we gotta do is clean up, haul that stuff over to the neighbor, and we're done. Have a good one. They cleared this area here, way down there, just to put some pipe in that they wanted to go from one gas well to the other. And the deer, I don't know what kind of feed they have on this, you know, what's growing there. But the deer yesterday, there were deer spread out from here all the way down to the other end of this thing. I couldn't believe it. I don't see any more down there. But last night they were all over the place. There's another one. You can see how nice looking that wood is. I'm sitting in the tractor just looking out there, and it's really beautiful pine boards.